Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Foolish Beauty. If you're new here, my name is TJ and welcome to my beauty and luxury lifestyle channel. Now today's video is going to be a little bit of a voiceover get ready with me video, which come to think of it, I don't think I've ever done before. And I am so sorry for the delay from my last video ever since I said I was going to be consistent. I know, so ironic. I actually got really, really ill straight after that. And because this was a voiceover video and I literally lost my voice for 2 whole weeks with the worst flu ever, so I couldn't finish this video at all. But here we are. I am feeling so much better. My voice is still a little bit croaky, but hopefully it should sound okay. Anyways, this get ready with me video is all about this look I did here a few weeks ago when I was invited by my Dior family to attend the preview of Dior Designer of Dreams exhibition at the prestigious London V&A Museum. I was so honoured to be invited. Dior has long been one of my favourite houses, so of course I really wanted to share this video with you guys of me getting ready, doing this beautiful makeup, and of course to walk you through a little bit of the event that evening as well. The Dior Designer of Dreams exhibition is still ongoing in London at the moment at the V&A Museum. So if you ever find yourself free on a weekend and you are really interested in Dior, the brand, or just haute couture altogether, then I highly, highly recommend getting yourself down to London. It is definitely an exhibition worth seeing. Starting off, I'm going to go in with my favourite Hollywood Flawless Filter from Charlotte Tilbury and just dotting that around very lightly on my face. High points mainly, and then going in with the It Cosmetics CC cream because this was an evening event and I wanted to add some more coverage. Using the MAC 133 brush, this will give me a very light coverage, but this is how I'm loving my base nowadays. The less product, the better. Setting all of this with the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Finish powder. This powder is so lightweight and has a really good oil control property as well. Moving on to brows, as always, I am using my trusty Innisfree Auto Eyebrow Pencil. This is in the shade Dark Brow. It's a very cool tone smoky brown which mimics my hair color very well, and I'm just filling in the sparse areas in the directions of the hair follicles. After filling in my brows off camera, I added just a touch of the Wunder brow gel. And this brow gel is so waterproof, I absolutely love it. To prime my eyes, I'm using the Nars Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Primer. This is the tinted version, the shade is Fair. I think I still prefer the translucent version, but hey, I gotta use it up. Now moving on to eyeshadow, going in with the Linda Hallberg palette, using the black shade in here, I'm just going to lay down the base of this very smoky eye look. This is a very buildable black. It's not too grey, but definitely not too intensely black. So it gives me lots of control as to how intense I want this shade to be. And as always, because of my hooded lid, I am taking this black all the way up to the crease area. And then going in with the more burgundy shade using my trustworthy Zoeva brush, I'm just going to really blend out and transition the black shade into my socket area. Moving on to a different palette, Yemoja. The burgundy shade in this palette seems to be a lot redder than the Linda Hallberg one, which is why I'm switching to this palette. I just really love the intense redness of this shade, which obviously slightly echoes with my hair. And I think in this instance, I just really wanted that pop of red in the transition area. And now I'm just adding a little bit more of that black so the two shades can mingle and mix and create that seamless transition. And then going in with my trustworthy Soap and Glory eyeliner, I'm just smoking out my lash line and elongating my lash line a little bit as well. Now onto the fun part, adding a bit dimension to the smoky eye in the form of glitter. And here I'm using the Lime Crime Diamond Dew in the shade Chocolate Diamond. It's such a beautiful shade. To smoke out the lower lash line, I'm adding a little bit of that burgundy shade from the Yemoja palette using my Zoeva 230 brush, and then adding a tiny bit more of shimmery burgundy here, I'm going in with the Clio Gel Presso Waterproof Eyeliner in the shade Bloody Devil. This is such a beautiful shimmering, I would say, pomegranate shade. It is my go-to shade when I want to add a bit of drama onto my lash line. And once again, I'm just blending that all out, making it as smoky as possible. To highlight the inner corner of my eyes, as well as starting on my cheek, I am using the brand new Becca x Chloe Malika palette. This is the Chloe version, which has lighter shades of blushes and highlighters. This is such a beautiful palette. I was really worried that the bronzer could be a little bit too warm to kind of contour with, but it actually was not, and I love all of the shades in here, and it is a beautiful traveling palette, so I think I'll definitely be bringing it on my travels with me this year. It is just so versatile and easy to use. Both of the blushes in this palette are quite glowy, which is the way I like it. And the highlighter in this palette, I was worried that it was going to be too dark for my complexion, but it turned out to be just fine, and it is actually surprisingly blinding. So beautiful. Now, to add a little bit more blinding factor, I am going into the Fenty Beauty Dimond Bond, my all-time favorite highlighter. It just adds that blinding factor, like I said, and I love a bit of glow. Now, because this look is super smoky and very glossy, I wanted to keep the lips neutral but glossy as well. So going in with Charlotte Tilbury's Lip Cheat Pencil in the shade Iconic Nude, I'm just lining the edge of my lips and then working the lip liners in with my fingers. This way it's going to look super natural and very soft. To finish the lips, I'm using the Jouer High Pigment Lip Gloss in the shade Maiden Lane. This is such a beautiful beigey nude lip gloss. The colour is amazing and the formulation feels absolutely comfortable. It's not too sticky at all and super glossy as well. After that, this look is complete. It is super smoky, very evening appropriate, yet super easy to achieve. And I hope you guys can see it also goes really well with my outfit, which is just a super simple sheer black dress that I bought ages ago. But of course, in honor of Dior's event, I had to accessorize it with all Dior jewelries. And of course, to attend the Dior event, it was the perfect excuse for me to use my Lady Dior bag. This is such a me outfit, all black, glossy, glittery. Yes. I absolutely enjoyed my makeup and outfit that evening. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I will leave you with a few more clips from the Dior Designer of Dreams exhibition. I so really enjoyed my time there. And once again, like I said, the exhibition is still on and it will be ongoing at the Victoria and Albert Museum in London until this summer. So please get yourselves down there if you're interested. And thank you so much again for watching. I really enjoyed doing this video. And if you enjoyed it as well, then please make sure you give it a thumbs up. You would really make my day. Thank you again for watching, my friends, and I shall see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.